Now, this Kiambu tour comes almost exactly a week after the International Criminal Court terminated the case against Deputy President William Ruto and former journalist Joshua Arap Sang. Even as the ICC suspects now walk free in Kenya, the hearing of the case filed by survivors of the 2007-2008 post-election violence against the government has been postponed to the 14th of April 2016. The case was filed by 8 survivors who were brutally gang-raped and forcibly circumcised, allegedly by state security officers as well as civilians. Michelle Ngele now reports.
More than 50 survivors of the 2007-2008 post-election violence showed up at the Milimani Law Court in Nairobi in solidarity with a group of 8 individuals who in 2013 filed a petition in the Constitutional and Human Rights Division of the High Court of Kenya seeking to compel the government of Kenya to address the sexual and gender-based violence that occurred during the post-election violence.
These are the 8 courageous survivors who've come out to be the face of the case in this particular, but their petition is seeking reparations, is seeking treatment, is seeking structures that will support not only the 8 of them, but all the other survivors of PEV who are out there.
We are requesting non-governmental organizations that are really trying much to help us, support us psychologically, keep it up. We are here for you. I would like to request the Court of Kenya. I think all the rulings have been done in ICC. We request Kenyan court to have, let us receive our justice if it is available.
In the aftermath of the violence, Kenyan leaders pledged, let's not be vague, let's go to Hague, perhaps thinking that the ICC would offer better justice. 6 years later, and victims and survivors of the violence are still a distressed lot. The perpetrators have not been prosecuted. Eric Kioko is one such victim, and he remembers all too well the brutality that befell him.
Nilisikia sauti ya mama akiwa chini na kulikuwa ni usiku saa 3. Mimi nilijua juu mara mingi sana hiyo time ni raping ilikuwa inaendelea sana. Na pia watu kukatoka na nyumba kuchomo. Nilipatana nao kwa kona watu wangapi, watu watatu. Mimi hata nikiinua mkono wangu wa kushoto, niliinua kama sijui. Nikagadi hivi tu na ikakato hapo hapo nikaanguka. Ilikatiwa hapa chini ya joint. Joint nilikuja kutolewa osi. Mimi nasema niliumia juu. Hii ndio nilikuwa natafuta nayo. Sasa niko hivyo. Yes, mimi ni DJ. Napata labda leo 500.
The petitioners claim that the government failed to properly train and prepare police to protect civilians from sexual violence, and that in its aftermath, the police refused to document and investigate claims of sexual and gender-based violence, leading to obstruction and miscarriage of justice. They now want the government to publicly acknowledge and apologize to the victims for their failure to protect the rights of Kenyans.
Kama sima victim, tulikam tukakuwa timu moja. Eh? Lazima tujifaitie. Lakini tunajaribu kujifaitia lakini tunaona hatuonekani.
Even speaking today, the wounds are still there. There has not been any reparations. There has never been any attempt even by the state to take the survivors through a process of healing. And that is what we want the court through an order to address and to direct the Kenyan state not just to ignore the challenge the survivors have faced. We want the survivors to have not only the reparations in court, but more importantly, they must go through a healing process.
The case at the High Court will resume on the 14th of April after the government asked for more time to go through the petitioner's claims. Michelle Ngele, KTN News.